Welcome to another regaling of strange fantasy. Obscure odysseys meant to shock the nervous system and stir the very core of your soul. In tonight's tale, we delve further into the tolling effects of Second Life. Rebirth can be a grueling metamorphosis to undertake. One spirit must be fearless in order to withstand the transformation. If fear lives, then you die. In this installment entitled, The Ballad of Necronancy, Part 2.
Here you go, honey. Stack of flapjack syrup on the side.
Thank you, ma'am.
Y'all enjoy.
All right. So you've been talking for nearly an hour now. Time to start making your point here, kid. What happened with Nancy?
Her Aunt Esmeralda told everyone that Nancy died that night at the concert. The school even held a memorial service for her that week before graduation. An assembly of the pathetic, forced to be lamented by the loss of a girl that they either laughed at or just simply dismissed. But I knew. Anastasia and I knew the truth. Do you have any idea what it's like to watch your best friend's funeral, all the while knowing that they're still alive? She had to be held up inside of her house. We tried the obvious, you know, but no one would answer the door, of course. So Anastasia and I began to research things.
Okay, I'll bite. Like what?
Information on the supernatural and the occult. Anything that could help us understand what happened to our friend. Well, so we started our research in her grandfather's private library.
Well, this is it. If there's any sort of answer that we could find, it'll be here.
Holy smokes. I don't even think the city library has these many books. Where the hell are we even supposed to start?
Over here. You work through the categorical nonfiction, and I'll make my way through measurable occult phenomenons and clandestine theories.
Okay. What exactly are we looking for?
Matthew, can you not yet see what's going on around you? Do you not see shadows move from the corner of your sight? Our friend is sick. She has a curse upon her soul, I promise you. If you'd only been there, seen what I had saw. She was dead.
I'm not so sure what to believe anymore.
You know as well as I do that Nancy's coffin was empty the day of her funeral. We cannot be blind to such unnatural suspicions, Matthew.
I really miss her.
As do I. And that is why we must continue to try and help her. The answer to Nancy's affliction lies somewhere within this old, dusty library. Now, come on, let's get to work.
Your grandpa sure has a lot of books on lycanthropy. What, like werewolves?
Precisely, dear boy. My affinities to knowing the unknown are documented all around you. A terrible malady, really. But it is what I've built myself on. A pleasure to make your acquaintance, dear boy. I am Anastasia's grandfather, Franklin Mutraba. And you must be Matthew.
Yes, sir. And the pleasure is all mine. Sir.
Anastasia, you did not mention that Matthew was such an upstanding gentleman.
Yeah, I must have forgotten. Grandfather, we are kind of busy right now.
Busy? Too busy to converse with your grandfather? As you peruse to his personal library, perhaps the old man could be of some use,
Grandfather, you know I hate it when you talk in the third person.
Are you ashamed of me, Anastasia?
No, of course not. Just not in front of company.
Fair enough. So Matthew, I believe you were discussing lycanthropy.
Yeah. Werewolves, right?
Yes. However, it is much more than that. This is no monster movie. It is a race of superior beings in their own right. That particular book you hold within your grasp happens to be my own writing. A perfectly historical understanding of their culture and evolution.
But werewolves aren't real, right?
A skeptic.
Grandfather, stop. Yini hashnu shtabonsno.
Om nam na rushik.
Please.
Should I go?
No, it's fine. Right, Grandfather?
Da. So, from what Anastasia has already informed me, your friend Nancy has not died, despite contrary belief. Duh.
Yeah, that about sums it up.
There are only three explanations that come to mind, expounded by a single definition. The undead.
The undead? Are you being serious?
Dead. Serious. The first explanation, she is a zombie. Brought on by ritualistic ceremonies or practices of the dark art. Enchanted, if you will. The second explanation, she's a vampire. Haunted by the sun, with a curious thirst for warm blood. A real conniving and acrimonious pack of animals. But that is just personal opinion.
Wait, so if zombie is one, and vampire is the second, what's the third explanation?
She's of something not yet understood. The unknown.
Jesus. This is crazy. Anastasia, do you actually believe this?
It seems the most logical.
What? Ugh, what are we talking about? We're talking about monsters of legend here. Myths. These things aren't real. And you're crazy if you think for a second that they are.
Spoken like a true skeptic. Crazy or not, that does not prevent the truth from being the truth. And you, my boy, will soon find out the validity of what is real, whether you'd like it or not. Curiosity will always bring things to light.
Great. So, how do we prove she's either one of those things?
Well, you must first prove that she still exists.
Nancy? May I come in?
Yeah, come on in, Aunt Ezzie.
Hello, dearie. How are you feeling?
Oh, so now you're ready to talk.
I'm deeply sorry, Nancy. I had to do what was necessary.
Had to? You didn't have to do anything. You killed me off. You buried me in an empty box. And now you want to talk? Ugh. Just leave me alone. I'd rather not be a blight on your conscience.
Nancy, please. I know this must be absolutely devastating for you. I had always hoped and prayed that this question would remain unanswered. But it is time to face the truth, Nancy. Your parents, Randy and Barbara Newman, are not real. They were made up as a comfort for you to live with. Just a warm memory.
What? They're not real. What do you mean they're not real? They died in a car accident when I was two. Un-Ezzie, please. Say something.
I'm not your real aunt. We have no blood relation. I am but a servant under your father's command.
My father?
Belas, one of the three remaining vampire kings. Nearly 19 years ago, a woman went traveling throughout the great hills of Romania. In the darkened woods, she happened to cross paths with the king himself. Not knowing her manners in the company of royalty, she showed no formal respect to the king and attempted to speak to him as an equal. The king, overtaken with the woman's humble charms and angelic beauty, had forgotten himself and began conversing with her. They talked far into the morning hours. The woman fawned a natural enchantment toward the king, as well as he toward her. However, the sun's light crept ever so surely through the darkened woods, and the king's vampiric blood broke his attention onto the creeping light. He beseeched the woman to come back with him to his castle chambers, so their love may be shared in peace. She agreed, quickly and willfully, and they leapt into the king's carriage and rode toward the castle. Her love made the king feel that his soul was no longer cursed, and she was madly in love with his humanity. Their love blossomed into the carrying of the king's child, an absolute miracle conception. In the 86 years I've served him, I had never seen the king so happy and at peace. I served as a midwife during her pregnancy, and the day you were born was the day she died. The saddest thing I have ever seen was her last breath and the king's silence. And then an infant's whimper. You were not of vampiric tendency, and there were no signs you showed of changing. To spare your life, the king thought it best to send you away, and I was appointed as your protector, to forever watch after you. But I have failed. I've failed you and the king and your mother.
What was her name?
Her name was also Nancy.
I have so many questions. What am I?
I must say, this is a most interesting effect caused by death. You're dead, yet still alive. But you are not a vampire. You are something else. Tell me, Nancy, how do you feel?
I'm not sure.
Close your eyes and think. Feel yourself. How do you feel?
Cold. I feel so cold. Numb. Like I'm almost frozen. I can still see with my eyes closed. I can see your face right now.
Let's try something. Can you see how many fingers I have up?
9, 4, 1, 6, 2.
Tell me what else you see.
I can see electricity. I can see the waves of current flowing throughout the house. If I follow it, I can see downstairs. The hallway, in the kitchen, I can see outside. I can see us sitting on my bed from outside my window. Holy moly.
Nancy, open your eyes.
Oh my God. Oh wow.
Nancy, open your eyes. Nancy!
I can't stop.
Nancy, lie back, dear. Lie back on your side. Shh. I've got you. Shh. Hush now, Nancy. Be still. It's going to be okay.
What's wrong with me?
You see, Fink, inside this man's chest sits the lifeless heart that will represent our conceptual frame. By the application of hyperionic energy, life can be seen as a little electric current going round and round. Forever onto infinity, it is apparent that electromagnetic fields can salvage a place within the biological dynamics. See how the electromagnetic fields are able to couple with the current of electron excitation? It sparks blue, yellow, then red. Such small reactions for such important consequences. Beautiful, isn't it?
Undoubtedly so, Dr. Cave. Serendipitous for us to have had that girl on your table last week. Her radiation residue was the clue you needed in order to calibrate the frequency.
However, the frequency is not quite there yet. Improvements and monumental strides have been made, yes, but nothing concrete. I must study more of that girl at once! Only she can definitively set the frequency to their correct coordinates.
Newspaper says they buried that girl's body just a few days ago at Lynchfield Cemetery.
There's no body in that casket, Fink. Didn't you already acquire her home address?
Yes, of course, Doctor. I was just anticipating the need for another fresh subject. I can never have too many. Plus, I enjoy grave robbing.
Yes, I too enjoy a good grave exhumation. Keeps the body fit. Ha! All right, you have got my buy-in, Fink. Let's go have a bit of fun for now. We'll grab a couple of new bodies for subject, and then we'll go pay a visit to Nancy, the young undead miracle girl.
Thanks for calling the Newman residence. Please leave a message after the beep.
Nancy. Nancy, I know you're there. Please pick up. Somebody please answer.
Nancy, please, come to the door.
Nancy, we just want to help. Please let us in.
What in the hell do you two think you are doing?
I'm sorry, Aunt Esmeralda, but we know Nancy's not dead.
Come inside. Now. Go upstairs to Nancy's room, and not another word.
Nancy? Nancy, are you there?
Hi, guys.
Nancy!
Oh, thank God, Nancy, baby doll.
We were so worried. God damn, you're pale. Oh, God. What happened to your hair? It's bleach white.
Yeah, about that. Maybe you guys should take a seat. I'm not sure how to tell you guys this, but I'm dead.
Yeah, we know.
That's why we're here, baby doll. We want to try and help.
Help with what exactly?
With whatever we can. I don't think anybody knows exactly how to best handle these types of situations. Because they're one-offs, but, you know, how often do your friends become the undead?
However you need us, we're here for you.
Thanks, guys. You're the best.
Aw, do not cry, baby doll. It's going to be all right.
I wish I could cry. I figured a lot of new things out about myself today. Such as my tear ducts don't work anymore.
That sucks.
Tell me about it. Oh, also, my real father is the king of all vampires or something.
What?
I know. Belas is how I think you say his name.
Wait, your father is Belas? Oh my God.
What are you doing?
Bowing in the presence of royalty, you ignorant fool. Bow, Matthew!
Okay.
You guys don't have to bow to me. I'm not royalty.
But you are, Nancy. You are the daughter of the one true vampire king. You are of the highest royalty.
Apparently not. He sent me away because I'm not like him. I'm not vampire enough.
Wait, so you are vampire?
Well, technically, I guess so. But I don't thirst for blood or anything like that. I'm still me, just a little different.
Yeah, right. You're dead.
Matthew!
What? It's true.
The correct term is undead.
Ugh, okay. Splitting hairs a bit at this point. Alright, fine. Undead. So, if you're not a vampire, what are you?
I'm not really sure. I can do these weird things, though. Like, with my mind.
Really? Like, what kinds of things?
Check this out.
Oh, sorry. Hang on. Let me see who this is. No caller ID. Who does that? Hello?
Hey, Matt.
Hey, who's this?
It's me, goofball.
Whoa. How the hell are you doing that? You're not actually talking.
I know. I'm talking to you with my thoughts.
That's freaking awesome.
You can hang up now.
Wow. That's pretty incredible. How did you do that?
I don't know. I can feel this energy all around me. In all things, and I can manipulate it, move it around, take or give to it. There's still a lot I don't understand, guys. I'm totally freaked out. I don't sleep. I hardly eat. I don't know what to do anymore. The world just looks so different now.
I'm sorry, baby doll. I know this must be frightening for you. Oh, Jesus, Nancy, your skin is ice cold.
Yeah, and then there's that. One of the many lovely side effects of being dead.
Maybe now Benjamin will fall for you.
Jesus, dude.
What? Too soon?
It's all right. It was kind of funny. Speaking of, did he show up to my fake funeral?
Oh, damn. I've been dying to tell you. Pun intended. Dude, he was totally misty-eyed when he wouldn't put a single red rose on your casket before they lowered it down. Oh my god, it was priceless.
Really? That's the best news I've heard in a while.
How is this good news? You can never see him again.
What? Why? Oh, don't say it's because I'm...
It's because you're dead.
You said undead earlier.
How is that any better?
Dang it! You just had to bring me back into reality.
This is a new and different reality now. Probably best to be present and living in it, instead of these perversely repressed fantasies you've got going on.
What? Yeah, you're probably right.
So, Nancy, do you have any other cool mind powers?
I don't know. Maybe. But do you know who might? That crazy doctor I met when I died. Or came back to life.
What? Absolutely not. He's the one that ran you over with his van and killed you. And he lied and took you away from us. You can't, Nancy. You can't.
All right. But when I woke up, he was in shock, of course. Who wasn't? But anyway, he said something about my levels being even higher than before.
Sounds pretty legit.
Right? So what I'm thinking is that out of anyone that we can think of right now, he would be most likely to have a reasonable explanation for what I've become.
You're undead. We've already talked about this.
But I need more. I just can't accept that I'm undead and simply move on with whatever kind of life this is now. I need help. I need the doctor.
God damn it. Fine, but I do not like this at all. Not one bit. You got me? I can't promise I'll be able to control myself around him if and when we ever see that doctor again.
Thank you, baby doll. You're the bestest.
Right on. So, how are we supposed to find him?
His laboratory is at the cross street between 52nd and Miller Road. If we leave now, we could be there before dark. Did you bring your car?
Yeah, got it. Let's get going.
Wait, we have to go out through my window. I'm pretty sure my Aunt Ezzie isn't gonna let me leave the house anymore. Especially not to do something like this.
Be careful, Nancy.
It's okay, don't worry. I don't think I can die again. Or at all. Or maybe I can. God, I can't wait to get some answers.
After you, Anastasia.
Thank you, Matthew.
Yeah, don't mention it. Jesus, this is gonna be such a long night.
Yes? How can I help you, gentlemen?
Ah, yes, ma'am. Does a young girl by the name of Nancy Newman live at this residence?
Not anymore. Nancy died almost 2 weeks ago. What's this about? Who sent you?
This is the right place, Fink. Apprehend the old wench.
Of course, Doctor.
Doctor? Hey, what the hell do you think you're doing? Unhand me, you bastard!
Very good, Fink. Very good.
So, why did we come to the cemetery again?
It's part of the grieving process. She needs to see her grave in order to cope with death. Wouldn't you want some closure if you were in her shoes?
Not really, no. I'd want to move on. Start over new. Nancy, do you really think this will help?
We'll be done soon. I don't want to stay long. I just gotta see it. Wait, is that Benjamin? Holy moly!
Get down!
Why? What are you doing? Let me go. He wants to see me.
Hey, why are y'all ducking behind a gravestone? Oh, hey, Benjamin's here.
Get down, you fool!
Ow. Okay. What the hell? You almost yanked my arm off. Jeez. It's a big deal.
Benjamin thinks that Nancy is dead, and it's probably better left that way.
I want to talk to him so badly. Do you think that's my grave he's standing over? It has to be, right?
Nancy, I don't think it's wise to bring him into our circle.
Just trust me. I bet he could help us.
With what exactly?
I don't know yet, but I'm sure he could.
Nancy, wait.
I'll be right back. Just wait for me here.
So, do you think you'll take it well?
We're about to find out.
Benjamin? Hey, it's me, Nancy.
Oh, God! Oh, that looked like it hurt. Guess it went well.
Man, he really smacked his head hard on that gravestone. Should I move him?
Maybe just poke him first.
Holy moly, is he okay?
Hey, Benjamin. You okay, bud?
Oh, my head. Damn it. What happened?
Well, you took off like a bat out of hell when you saw Nancy.
Hello.
Am I dreaming?
Afraid not, bud. But you'll get used to how weird all this is shortly.
Nancy? How? I watched them bury you. How is this possible?
The coffin was empty.
How are you alive?
I don't know. That's kind of what we're trying to figure out.
What brings you out to the cemetery so late?
I thought seeing my grave would help me. What about you?
I was mourning a loss.
Okay, so are you two just gonna stare at each other all night, or are we gonna try and, find some answers?
What kind of answers are you looking for?
Nancy met this doctor who might know more about her miracle resurrection. Oh. So, we gotta find him to find the answers.
And are you sure that's what you want? You can't give back knowledge.
I already lost my life, so might as well embrace the unknown, right?
That's one way of looking at it.
Right. So, anyway, this is a real nice reunion and all, but we really gotta get going. Right, Nancy?
Huh? Oh, yeah, right. Do you want to come with us, Ben?
I've got nothing going on.
Great. Can we get going now? I hate the cemetery.
Yes, let's go.
I've got my hog with me. You want to ride?
Sure. I mean, yeah, that's cool.
Right on. I'm really glad you're, alive.
Somewhat. I never figured you'd notice I was gone.
Why would you think that?
Well, for starters, this is the longest conversation I think we've ever had. I just didn't think you knew I existed.
By the way, I dig your new look. The hair's a nice touch.
Holy moly.
I think I have a spare helmet somewhere. Hang tight. Ah, here we go.
Thanks.
No problem. So, where are we heading?
52nd and Miller Road.
Damn. That's kind of far out of town, huh? What's a doctor doing in the middle of nowhere?
Baby doll, are you sure you're going to be alright on that death machine?
I think I'll be okay.
Alright. Matthew and I will be behind you the entire time, okay?
God, you're starting to sound like my Aunt Ezzy. We'll be fine. Now let's go before it gets too late.
Hang on tight. Whoa, hey, you're ice cold.
Yeah, sorry. You get used to it.
Here, take my jacket.
Much better. Thanks.
Is this place? We've been driving for nearly an hour.
I don't know. Never been there before. Jeez. You know what's crazy? That night we found Nancy, she must have walked all this way to the point where we picked her up by her house. That's like over 60 miles. At least.
Poor girl. I feel so awful for her. She doesn't realize it yet, but a life lived in the shadows is to have never lived at all.
Yeah. Hey, so... what's up with you lately?
What do you mean?
I mean, it feels like you don't want to tell me everything. You know, I looked up what your grandfather said earlier in the library. Obnam Narushik means he'll find out soon. What did he mean by that?
I don't know how to explain this to you yet, Matthew. There are things about me that I fear, and if you knew, you would run.
Try me. It can't be any crazier than anything else that's going on. I mean, how bad could it honestly be at this point? Nancy is some sort of undead thing with mind powers. And her real dad is a super old vampire king. What? Let me guess. You're a werewolf or something. What? What's wrong? Why are you looking at me like that?
No!
Really? A werewolf?
Why do you laugh? Out of fear?
No.
Then why?
Because that's pretty badass.
What?
Hell yeah! This day just keeps getting better. First, Nancy's alive. Somewhat, you know. Second, vampires are real. Cool. And now, you're telling me that not only werewolves are real, but you, yourself, are in fact one.
Yeah.
That's pretty badass. Your grandfather too?
Yeah, he taught me everything I know.
So, what's it like?
Lonely, mostly. For women, being a werewolf is different. We can shift at will, and we develop more of a control over the urge. When our male counterparts, on the other hand, can only shift during the cycle of the full moon, and the urge consumes them.
Whoa. That is intense. So, you could shift right now?
I would need more room, but yeah, I could.
Does it hurt when it happens?
Kind of. But after a while, the pain starts to feel good. Like stretching as you first wake up.
Neat. I think I...
Hey, we're here!
Yep. That's what I was gonna say. I think we're here. Yay.
Hey, wait. So, you really are not afraid of me?
I am. But it's a good kind of fear. I trust you. And I know that you wouldn't hurt me.
Unless you asked.
What?
Come on, handsome, let's go.
Holy moly.
Hey, guys.
Hiya, baby doll.
What's with the pie-eating grin?
What? No, nothing. Why are we here?
All right, so this dirt path leads up to the doctor's lab. It's about a 10-minute walk if we hurry.
Walk? Why walk?
Because I don't want us to get noticed, doofus.
Hey, if I may say something, there's headlights coming over that hill. If you don't want to get spotted just yet, now's the time to hide.
Whoa! Everyone duck in the bushes!
Ow, you're on my hand.
Sorry. Shh. Here it comes.
That's the same van that ran you over.
What?
Oh, yeah. This doctor we're going to see may have been responsible for initially killing me?
Again. What?
Yeah, I know. It's screwed up. But that doesn't take away from the fact that he's the only one that might have some answers for me. Please, try and understand.
Guess you haven't mentioned your dad yet.
Dude. My dad's a vampire king, and my mom was mortal. They had me, my mom died, my dad sent me away to protect me or whatever, and everything in my life up to a couple of weeks ago has been one giant lie. I died, and I came back. I'm half vampire, and I don't drink blood. There, are we all cut up now?
Do you still eat and drink?
Not really. I don't get hungry, and everything I try to eat and drink all tastes the same, like rye toast and lemon water. Can we please get going now?
Yes, baby doll. Let's go.
Damn.
Come on. You get used to it. Let's catch up. Jesus, this is a laboratory?
The lab is inside.
Yeah, well, from the outside, this looks like an abandoned factory.
Look, there's the doctor's van.
And there's the door I walked out of that night. Come on.
Hey, Nan, your Aunt Izzy's here.
What? How do you know that?
Yeah, I can see her through the window over there. Hey, she sees me. Hi. Why is she shaking her head? No.
Oh, God. They got her tied up. We gotta help her.
Well, that sucks. You need a key card to open the door.
Watch out. I got this. Come on.
Cool.
No need to hide, Nancy. I already knew you would be here. You see, we want the same thing, dear Nancy.
You guys stay here. And what's that, Doctor?
Answers. What's best for both of us? We can help each other, Nancy. Learn from each other. I want to help you. My, oh my, just look at you. You're hardly decaying at all. The pale skin and the white hair are a given, though. More than likely, your heart rate has slowed too. If I must guess by the looks of you, less than 15 beats in a single day, causing blood to no longer flow as fast throughout the body. I'm also willing to bet that you're very, very cold, aren't you?
Freezing. Now I talk and you answer.
I am all ears.
First, why do you have my aunt tied up? She looks hurt. Did you hurt her?
Well, I suppose so. Just a little. The majority of her injuries were self-inflicted if she just hadn't struggled so much.
And you did this just to get to me?
Why else? If I'd only known your intentions were to seek me out, perhaps I would have been more patient. Nevertheless, I'm not a very patient man to begin with.
Untie her now.
No.
Untie her!
The answer is, and always will be, no! You do not frighten me, poor child. Death does not frighten me. I know death like an old friend. There is no leverage with death. You, however, like all others, fear what you do not know, letting it consume you until every waking moment is spent in fear of death. And when it finally comes, when all the chips are down, and you're taking in your last breaths, you will still cower. Pathetic. My turn has come yet again for questioning. Tell me, what are you?
I'm angry.
Already?
Getting there. My turn. What do you want?
Fine. What I want is for my research, my life's work, to come to fruition. For so long, I've poured myself into making my dreams a reality. Now that I have you, there's nothing that can prevent my work.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about second life, little girl! Having the upper hand. Domination on death itself! No more will society live in fear of death. They will live and walk amongst it. You see, the bulk of my research and knowledge is centered around the effects of the interactions between electromagnetic energy, living and non-living matter. Biological research thus far in history has only concentrated on theories of substance, dealing only with the living. If you ask me, that's like reading only half of a good book, so I am reading the other half. Oh, the wonderful mysteries that lie in wait to be discovered.
You're insane. I didn't want to believe it, but hearing the words you speak, the dedication behind each thing you say, scares me. Not because I don't understand, because I believe you. You are a very, very dangerous man, Doctor.
Oh, stop. You are too kind.
Listen,
I'm leaving with my aunt. And you, just leave us alone.
I'm afraid I can't let you get away from me a second time. You're part of something bigger than yourself now, Nancy.
I want nothing to do with you. You're mad. You need help.
I will ask you once more. Stay. And help me complete my work.
No.
God damn it! Why not? I have the leverage here, me! You've got nothing! Submit to me! Submit!
I've got something.
What do you have?
Friends.
Ah, so you do. Hello, Nancy's friends. How do you do? This doesn't change anything. I still have control. And you've only got 3 friends.
That's right. Last time I checked, 4 against 1 are pretty good odds. Now, untie my aunt.
No.
Listen here, guy. I don't give a good goddamn who you think you are, or whatever the hell it is you want to do. Nancy said to untie her aunt. So do what the lady says, yeah?
If this is how you want things to go down, then fine. Nancy, you're free to untie yourself.
Fine. Don't move. Aunt Ezzy, oh my goodness, are you okay?
Come on, let's go.
Of course. Here, get her to the car.
You say it's like you're not coming with.
I'll be right behind you. I just gotta find something out real quick.
We can wait.
Hey, what's the holdup? Let's go.
Nancy?
What are we waiting for, Nancy?
Just hang on. Hey, Doc, are you gonna leave us alone?
Not a chance.
Why?
Let me show you. If you'll just stand right here for a moment, thank you.
What does that giant machine do?
Put simply, it is a machine that can give and take electromagnetic energy and refine it into a pulse of which I can reanimate anything, so long as I am attuned to the proper frequency. Can you imagine? The theoretical possibilities are overwhelming. Think about it. No more death.
And what does this have to do with me?
You're the key. The answer that I've been seeking for decades. You are a miracle, Nancy. You are alive again.
Do you believe in the unknown, Doctor?
Of course I do. I am a scientist. The unknown is of our nature.
Then believe me when I say, there are forces out there, things that we pass off as nothing but fairy tales and imagination, things of legend. These things are real. And I may be alive again, but it is not because of science. I'm not sure there's a way to measure what I am.
Things of fantasy are often derived from facts of science. There's always a scientific explanation to be had, believe you me.
Last time I was here, you had an assistant. Where is he?
Fink? Glad you asked. He's been above us, awaiting my signal to throw the switch!
What?
Here, let me show you now, Fink!
Yes, Doctor!
Yes! Yes! Feed my machine! Throw the second switch!
Nancy! Let her go!
Look away, son! She's a goner!
God damn it! I said let her go! Doctor!
Oh! Oh! You stupid son of a bitch! You're a terrible shot! Oh, hit me right in the upper abdominal quadrant, you bastard child! Ah! Oh, Fake! Where are you?
I'm here, Doctor. I'm here. Oh, God, they've shot you!
Yes, Fink. I am aware. Why are you down here, you idiot? Quickly run and throw a third switch!
Yes, Doctor!
Run, Fink!
Hey, asshole! What do I gotta do to release her?
It is far too late now. There is nothing you or I can do.
The machine is fully primed! As soon as Fink throws a third switch, the machine will do what it was designed for.
And what's that?
It will send out a hyperionic pulse, roughly 60 miles in diameter. The power will be great enough to raise the dead. The world will know my work was not in vain. My name will live on in infamy.
We'll just see about that, asshole.
Wait, wait, wait! What are you doing? Get away from her! Throw the switch! Throw it!
Go get him, Nancy!
You stupid fool! It's too late! It's too late! I will give life!
Nancy, wake up! We gotta get going.
What's happening?
Come on, Nan, we gotta go.
Wait, where's my Aunt Ezzy?
She's safe.
And Benjamin?
I'm sorry. He's gone.
What? Oh, God. Benjamin.
Nancy, we don't have time. Come on.
No, I have to end this once and for all. Hey, Dr. Psycho.
Ah. The unstoppable girl. Still alive, I see.
Tell me how to stop this machine.
There's no stopping the inevitable. In less than 90 seconds, I win.
Matthew, I need you to leave.
What? Hell no. I ain't going nowhere.
Matthew! I said leave!
I'm not leaving you behind!
It's okay. I have to do this. This is why I was given a second life. Let me do this.
But man, please.
All right. Nobody move or I'll shoot.
Good job,
Fink.
Thank you, Dr. Ein.
Holy moly!
Whoa,
an upright werewolf, eh? Jesus, now I've truly seen everything.
What's that thing with you?
Fink! Fink, are you alright?
I love you, Fink.
I'm afraid your companion is dead.
Anastasia?
Hi, Nan.
Hey, none of this is gonna matter in about 30 seconds.
Oh, he's right, you know.
Shut it! Listen, thank you both for everything. For being my friend, I love you guys, but you need to leave now.
Nancy, we can't just...
Please, just leave, and don't look back.
Come on, Matthew, let's go.
What? No, I'm not leaving her behind, no freaking way.
Then I'm sorry for this.
Oh.
Nice right hook.
Goodbye, baby doll. I love you.
Seconds.
You want to know the difference between you and me?
There is no difference.
Oh, but there is. I'm the good guy.
Forgive me, Master. Yes, Master. I'll be there soon.
And that's it. That's how Nancy saved us all. Please, Mr. Dancer, you've got to tell her story.
That's a hell of a yarn you spun, Matt, but how do I know any of what you said is true? Where's your proof?
Join me outside for a smoke.
Yeah, sure.
So, Mr. Dancer, you asked for proof. I'd like to think that I'm a man of my word.
That's great, kid. Words are one thing, but hard proof is what the truth is based on.
Yeah. Understood. Follow me. I want to show you something.
Why are we in an alleyway? Listen, kid, if you're gonna mug me, I ain't got nothing worth taking.
I would never, Mr. Dancer. We're the good guys.
We?
Yeah. Mr. Dancer, I'd like to introduce you to my girlfriend, Anastasia.
Wolf? Where? What? What the hell?
I told you, it was all real.
When shadows arise, they may never fall. Ascended to a realm of obscurity, where they will wither and die for all eternity. However, it is possible for shadows to return. Thus concludes tonight's libretto of strange fantasy. Tune in next week for another look into the strange and obscure.
Libretto's A Strange Fantasy presented The Ballad of Necro Nancy, Part 2, written and produced by Travis Scarborough and Trey Gonzalez. The players of tonight's tale are as follows: Tennyson Strano as Nancy Newman, Courtney Michelle Hafner as Anastasia Otrava, Travis Scarborough as Matthew, Trey Gonzalez as Dr. Cave, Heath Allen as Fink and Elton Dancer, Martina Olhauser as Aunt Esmeralda, Veronica Orozco as the waitress, and Dale Russell Green Jr. as Benjamin. Librettos of Strange Fantasy is copyright 2017 Burke Funk Media, all rights reserved. All characters appearing in this work are fictitious. Any resemblance to real persons living or dead is purely coincidental. Librettos of Strange Fantasy will return with Season 3 in the fall of 2017.